The question here, the letters written through one focus subtends a right angle at the further vertex of the hyperbola, then its eccentricity is whatever. Four options are there. Okay. Just observe here. L dash is the letter setup here. L dash is the letter setup passing through one focus here. Okay. Here A is the one vertex. A dash is the one more vertex here. Here further vertex, they given here. Okay. So here they given letter setup through focus subtends a right angle at the further vertex. Okay, is the further vertex here. So here this angle here. Total this angle is 90 degrees. Right angle here. Okay. Then what is the eccentricity of this hyperbola here? Okay. Here in this case, you know that this distance is always a unit here. OA dash means this one. Here this distance is a unit here. And this distance OS. OS is a A into E here. OS is a E into E. Therefore, total this distance here, A dash S becomes a A plus E here. Total distance is A plus A into E. Okay. So in this case, L A dash L dash 90 degree here. Angle. So L A dash L dash is equal to 90 degree. Yes, sir. Here L A dash S is a 45 degree here. Therefore, angle L A dash S L A dash S is equal to 45 degree. So if this angle is a 45 degree, then this angle is also 45 degree because this angle is a 90 degree. If this is 90 degree, this is the 40. So L A dash S L A dash S is a 45 degree. And this is a 90 degree. Hence, this angle is a 45 degree. So, A dash L S. Therefore, A dash L. L S is equal to 45 degree because angle of A dash S L. A dash S L is a 90 degree. Okay? So, because this angle is a 45 degree, this is a 90 degree, therefore this angle is also 45 degree. If both angles are 45 degree, then it is a isosceles triangle here. In isosceles triangle, two sides are equal. Yes, sir. You can write here A dash S is equal to L S S. Okay, therefore A dash S is equal to L S S. Okay, so because this angle is a 45 degree. This angle is also 45 degree. Yes, sir, these angles are equal. Therefore, corresponding sides are also equal here. A dash S is equal to L S here. And A dash S is this one here. A plus A. Therefore, A plus A is equal to. And L S is the length of the semi-letter set here. This L S here. Here, this is a B square upon A. So it is a b square upon a. Even this is also what here? B square divided by. Here we all know this distance here. Yes, sir. LS is a b square divided by a. B square divided by a. Here a is a common factor here. A common 1 plus e is equal to b square divided by a square. Take a this side here. 1 plus e is equal to b square divided by a square. Okay. Then here it is a hyperbola. In this hyperbola, we know that e square is equal to, okay, 1 plus b square divided by a square. For the hyperbola, eccentricity e square is equal to 1 plus b square by a square. Here b square upon a square is what here? 1 plus e. So use here. So e square is equal to 1 plus e here. Yes, e square. Take e left side here, this is a minus e. Then 1 plus 1 is 2. Take it to left hand side here, minus 2 is equal to 0. And it is a quadratic equation here. Okay, this is a quadratic equation. Yes, sir, two numbers are minus 2 and plus 1 here. So e square minus of 2e plus e minus 2 is equal to 0, and here e common factor here, so e minus of 2, and here 1 is the common here, so e minus 2 is equal to 0. Hence e minus 2 into e plus 1 is equal to 0, so e is equal to 2 or e is equal to minus 1 here. So for the hyperbola, eccentricity always greater than 1. Hence e is equal to 2 is the answer here. Therefore eccentricity of hyperbola is e is equal to 2. Okay, therefore obviously here the third option is correct. C is correct. Okay, here I written a square here, but here only a here. Okay, after taking a this side, then it becomes a square. Okay, b square upon a square is equal to 1 plus c. Use this one here. Okay, 1 plus c, take a left side here, 1 plus 1 becomes 2 here, minus 2 here, and simplify, we get a is equal to 2 and equal to minus 1. For hyperbola, eccentricity is always greater than 1 here. Therefore, e is equal to 2 is the correct option. Okay, the question. The letter circum of a hyperbola through one of the focus subtends 60 degree at the other focus, then its eccentricity is what here? Okay, so L dash here. Okay, so that's it. Is the letter circum here, and S dash is the one more focus here. S is the one focus, S dash is the one more focus. Then here L dash here makes angle 60 degree at the S dash here. This angle is 60 degree here. Then obviously this angle is 30 degree here. This angle L S dash S is 30 degree, and this is 90 degree here. Okay, therefore here tan of here angle L S dash L dash is equal to 60 degree. Therefore so L S dash and S is equal to 30 degree. Therefore tan 30 degree. So tan of 30 degree. This angle is 30 degree. Tan is opposite divided by adjacent side here. L S divided by S dash S here. So this is equal to L S divided by S dash S. Tan 30 degree value is 1 divided by root 3 S. It is a standard result here. And L S is the length of the semi-letter sector. Length of the semi-letter sector. Hence so this is b square upon a. Okay. So it is a b square divided by a. B square divided by a divided by S S dash here. Distance between foci. Distance between foci is 2 a e. 2 a into a. Okay, S dash S is the distance between foci. S is the length of the semi letter circum here. Now take a to denominator here, and 2 in this end here. 2 into e divided by root of 3 is equal to b square divided by a square here. Take a to denominator, a to a become a square, take a 2 into e this end here. Okay, we get this one. So it is a hyperbola. We know that. So we know that here a square is equal to 1 plus b square divided by a square here. Hence a square 1 plus b square upon a square is this one here. 2e divided by root 3. So 2e divided by root of 3. Therefore a square is equal to root 3 is the LCM here. Root 3 into 1 becomes root 3 plus 2 into e here. Okay, take root 3 this side here. Root 3 into e square is equal to root 3 plus 2 into e here. Take both term left side here. So root 3 into e square minus of 2e minus of root 3, that is equal to 0. Again it is a quadratic equation here. Root 3 into root 3 becomes 3 here. So product should be minus 3. And the middle minus 2 is there. So it is a minus of 2 here. So two numbers are obvious it is a minus 3 plus 1 here. Therefore, root 3 e square minus 3 into e plus e minus of root 3 is equal to 0. Minus 3 e plus e becomes a minus 2 e here. Then from these two terms here, root 3 into e common factor, root 3 into e common here, then remaining here e minus of root 3 here. And here one common factor, so 1 is the common here, e minus of root 3, that is equal to 0. Then e minus root 3, even here also e minus root 3, take care outside here. E minus root 3 into root 3 into e plus 1, root 3 into e plus 1 is equal to 0. Yes, e is equal to root of 3 and e is equal to minus 1 divided by root 3. Okay, you know that for the hyperbola, eccentricity is always greater than 1 here. So, eccentricity of a hyperbola is equal to root 3 here. Therefore, B is the correct option here. Okay, therefore, here e is equal to root of 3. Because the eccentricity of a hyperbola is always greater than 1 here. So, it is equal to if the letters and term subtends a right angle at the other focus of a hyperbola, then its eccentricity is what here? Okay. Let's take a previous example. In the previous example, here the angle is 60 degree, but here this angle is 90 degree. If this angle is 90 degree, then obviously this angle is 45 degree. If this is 45 degree, then this angle is also what here? 45 degree. Okay, therefore, here angle L S dash L dash is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, L S dash S is equal to 45 degree. Okay. Therefore, tan of 45 degree. Tan 45 degree is equal to, okay, again opposite divided by adjacent side here, LS divided by S dash S here. Okay, so LS divided by S dash S. Tan 45 degree value is 1 here is equal to, and LS it's a length of the semi letter set here, it's the B square divided by A. So LS is a B square upon A. And S dash S here is the distance between foci. Distance between foci is 2A into E here. Take 2E this side here. So 2 into E is equal to B square divided by, take it to denominator, it becomes A square. Therefore, for hyperbola, A square is equal to 1 plus B square divided by A square here. B square upon A square is 2 into E. So, use here. So, E square 1 plus 2 into E here. Take 1 plus 2 E left hand side here. E square minus 2 E and minus of 1 here. That is equal to 0. Again, it is a quadratic equation here. So, direct you can't simplify. Therefore, use this formula. Plus or minus root of B square minus of 4ac divided by 2a is this formula. Yes, e is equal to minus of minus 2 here. Plus or minus root of minus 2 square. Minus 2 square minus 4 into a value is 1 here. And c value is minus 1. Okay. Therefore, minus of 1 divided by 2 into a value 1 here. 2 into 1. Therefore, E is equal to minus of minus becomes a plus 2 here. Plus or minus root of. Here 2 square is a 4 here. It is a 4. Minus into minus becomes plus here. So again it is a plus 4 here. 4 plus 4 becomes 8 divided by 2. Okay. Therefore, this is equal to 2 plus or minus root of 8 means 2 root of 2 here. Divided by 2. 2 is the common factor here. 2 common here, 1 plus or minus root 2 divided by 10. This 2 and this 2 get cancels here. Therefore, here E is equal to 1 plus or minus root 2 is there. 1 plus root 2 or 1 minus of root 2 here. But here eccentricity is always greater than 1 here. For the Hyperbola law, eccentricity greater than 1. So obviously this is the answer here. Therefore, E is equal to 1 plus root 2 here. Therefore, the answer is B. 2 plus 1 is the correct option.